You know, he goes coast to coast, and he takes that car with him, running that Ford, and it seems to have a mind of its own for some reason.
Yeah, just a little bit off and on. See, there is a Chevrolet Clarion on hand with us. I thought he got rid of him last night. I don't know. I thought you'd give him your car instead of that car.
Well, the thing is, that works better than mine does, but he should get out, he should party a little bit. You know, we got a lot of friends over in the Wild Side. We went up to the Fleet Auto Sales set over there in the mobile home, and they keep promising to cook for you and me. I think we're going to have to go do that sometime.
Oh, a lot of people on the Wild Side is going to come. Let's talk about some upcoming events as we get ready to get in between Chevrolet USA and also upcoming features and the I-44 Chevrolet drivers once again. All drivers in the first of the check barn. For a big driver's meeting, if you would, please.
Hey, Speedo, what's behind you? The car's hot. That thing's got a mind of its own. You better back up, too. That's a car's going to shoot some fireworks at you. That's called a hot backside. All five divisions are set to run around. He's talking about a lot of great corporate sponsors helping to make the racing competition possible. Located in Lebanon, I think they're celebrating the second or third anniversary right now of the summer. The Get Your organization. Boy, it's great to have them along with us.
That's right. Located right there off of North Highway 5 in Lebanon, Missouri. And, yeah, Get and Go open 24 hours to serve you. We got a lot of fine board sponsors, but real quick, Bob, we got some great upcoming events along with what's going to be featured that night for some extra dollars, and let's talk about what's coming up.
Oh, we really do. Next week, of course, is Friday night. Action Track will be giveaway night with extra laps for the late model. It's still following you, Tito. You better pick that pace up a little bit. Late model stocks running extra laps next Friday night. At Speedway USA next Saturday is a Fleet Auto Sales night with the Bomb Squad and the Super Stocks running extra laps for extra cash here at the I-44 Speedway. And then some of the real big nights coming up, some of the other ones, NASCAR Souvenir Night, Friday, July 22nd with extra laps from Grand American Late Model. Military Night will be July 23rd with Late Model Stocks on hand for extra laps and extra cash here at the I-44 Speedway. And, you know, we mentioned the Fleet Auto Sales. Got some of the racing hats we want to pass out to the fans. Haul out those tickets, Dubs. Ticket number 66251. 66251. That's yours. Go ahead and get it to town. We'll go ahead and pass it out to you. And another McLean Auto Sales racing hat from supporters of Ken Dickinson, number 21, Grand American Late Model. Ticket number 66315. 66315. That's yours. Please send it to town. More than happy to pass it out to you this evening. A lot of fine folks up here to make their racing competition possible. I want to welcome aboard Jim Professional Auto Repair on Highway 54 in Osage Beach. It's in Rockdown, Lake Road 6456. And if you're looking for lunch or dinner sometime during the week, head to South Jefferson, head to Western Sizzlin' in Lebanon. They've been serving the area for an awful long time. Frank and his crew do just a super job of putting together whatever you might want, including great lunch and dinner buffet. Speedo, you can't seem to shake that car. It's still following you. That thing's got a mind and a temperament of its own. It seems to be faster than you are. McDonald's also helping bring you the racing competition this evening. You hang on to those ticket stubs, and after the race, you go to McDonald's and you purchase yourself a large sandwich. They will give you a free medium soft drink. That's McDonald's, Lebanon. Springfield Engine Supply also on hand for the 1994 NASCAR Winston Racing Series. Springfield Engine Supply, home of the Street Pro, 863-1931 is the number to contact. Trying to get that wave started over there, Speedo. Well, I tell you what, you can get those fans involved. I imagine we can even get the horns and lights going as the night winds on, too. Of course, Automobilia is on hand with us as one of the corporate sponsors of the NASCAR Winston Racing Series, along with Auto Air and Audio, located in Springfield. They've been doing a lineup on the wild side every now and then. 831-7320 is the number to contact Auto Air and Audio in Springfield. And, of course, after the race, it's race time. They had the Big Daddy Spence. Boy, those rocket engines are working. You can run a little faster if you want to get away from that Ford, Speedo. Boy, he put on a great show last night at the Friday Night Action Track. Peterina was there, but she was a little bit disappointed. That Speedo's look-alike, good-looking sister. Tried to set a brand new track record last night at Speedway USA, but had some problems. And just... Here it comes again, Speedo, look behind you. But Speedarena is here. Rumor has it she is down in pit house, getting ready to go, trying to set that track record again this evening. Fastest time down the straightaway with those rocket engines. We're going to see that. You're running out of track to work with. You're not going to be able to get away from that car, Speedo. What are you going to do now? There's a dead end. You're going to dive down to the infield. That's a long, long run of springy. Yeah, the car can't climb, can it? Hey, and of course, during intermission this evening, Speedo's going to be on hand. And we'll sign autographs for you absolutely free, so the youngsters want to go ahead and get set for that during intermission this evening. Speedo's also got some glossies that he'll be selling for a couple of bucks. T-shirts are also on sale this evening for the adults and for the... You found a friend already, didn't you? You should. Yeah. Hey, that Ford's got a mind of its own, got the lights or the eyes that work. I got a funny feeling a little bit later on tonight, we might find out who's actually in charge, whether it's Speedo or the car. And I think I know the answer to that, and it's not that clown. Speedo's going to pull down low on the track, and I tell you what, he's going to be with us throughout the evening. He travels coast to coast, putting on shows across the state. Former race car driver himself in the pod business for better than 20 years. Fans, what do you say one time for Speedo, the Speedway Clown? And you know, I had a chance to talk to Speedo earlier tonight. It was a very intellectual kind of evening because you travel coast to coast, but you have never seen race fans with the enthusiasm that people have here at the I-44 Speedway. So we're going to need your help throughout the evening, getting everyone fired up and ready to go, because he's got some things in store for us this evening, including a national anthem display like you just absolutely will not believe. Because Speedo, of course, is very, very patriotic. Hey, I got a great, you want to run for president? What do you think? Does Speedo run for president in a couple of years? And you can wear that tie. Might need to get your jacket to go with it, though. The thing I want to know, though, Speedo was supposed to be running tailback in the Pier Street main event this evening. Why isn't he at that driver's meeting right now? And you thought you had a fireworks display last week on Independence Weekend. There's an old saying that you ain't seen nothing yet. Drivers' meeting still going on down at the pit house. We'll be having our parade of sponsors in just a couple of moments and then getting set for the racing competition tonight. Looks like that driver's meeting just about to break.
Yeah, but see, I know his car won't. He's lucky if he finds his way here also. Well, I don't have to worry about it. Rosie just gets me here. I just go to sleep in the back end. Next thing I know up, we're right here at I-44 Speedway. What do you think of this place, Speedo? You've been all over the United States, a lot of dirt tracks and asphalt tracks.
This is probably one of the nicest facilities I've ever seen. I mean, as far as big, I think you fans ought to give yourself a big hand for having a nice racetrack here. Give yourselves a big hand. This place is great. It really is. And if I had about $4 or $5 million, I'd just buy this thing and sleep right in the middle of it.
Oh, yeah, Bill's done a beautiful job. We had a monster truck on a drag pull, I think, about 2-3 weeks ago, and kind of ruined the grass a little bit, but they did a good job. He does, and of course, we call that the wild side over there. That's Deer Parking. Hey, buddy! Anybody up there on the wild side? All right. Let's see what kind of response I can get from the grandstand side. All right, grandstand, everybody. Boy, they're lightweights over there. Come on now, back to the wild side. Let's hear ya. Blow your horn. All right, here we go. One more time up here in the grandstand side. Now, everybody really get serious. On three. One, two, three. All right. One more time on the wild side. One, two, three. That's good. Boy, I'll tell you what, you guys are all right over there. I'll tell you what do you want to say? Let's go one. No, not yet. We'll say that just a little bit. Oh, do I get to say that? I'll think about it. Depends on how good you are. Now, he's going to pout. You are brothers with ale. He gets mad, he pouts. You even got the same shoe size. I can see that already. Speedo, I'm going to ask you. I know your address is not forwarded very much. Originally, where are you from?
Originally, I'm from California. And I used to drive modifieds out in California. And then I got rid of the modified and decided I wanted to be a clown. I've been a clown ever since.
Well, you just hang back right now, because here in just a couple of minutes, that beautiful Leslie Auto Sales Ford Mustang, and you got a Ford there too. Leslie Auto Ford. You got all Fords?
Yes, sir. I got a Ford F-350 diesel, and I got a Model A Ford. Right, Rosie? And I'm a Ford man. How many of you fans up there are all Ford people up there? Any Ford people? All right. Oh, Henry had a good idea, didn't he? And he's still planning to do it. All right. Here in just a minute or two, our parade of sponsors will be rolling out. And Bob, of course, we mentioned, Vito, you're going to stay around for the whole race tonight?
Oh, sure I am. I'm going to be up in the grandstand during the intermission and stuff. I got some pictures to sell, and I'll sign autographs on anything. As long as the kids keep coming, I'll keep signing autographs. And I might even make it up there to Tightwater Hill over here in the back.
Why do you call it Tightwater Hill?
Well, when they come here, they ain't tight, but when they leave, they are.
We even got them their own board sponsors, you notice that?
Right here in the front chute. These people can't read it, but up on the mountain, you guys got it. Here's your sponsor right here, guys. What about the Budweiser wagon up there? Hi, guys.
Yeah, they can hear us a little bit. They're just getting ready to settle down. That place doesn't come to life. They got the lights all ago, but when it gets dark, then they get lively.
Oh, that's the way Rosie is. Right? Hey!
Hey, Ronnie, I'd back up if I were you.
Peter, you must have made her awful mad.
She thinks I'm him.
Oh, is that what the deal is?
Yeah, remember, I was a nice one to you last night. He was the one that was mouthy.
I remember that. Rosie owes you one.
Well, right now, Fido, as you watch, we're going to see a beautiful parade sponsorship as our Leclerc Auto Sales Ford Mustang will lead out what we call our parade of sponsors.
Is that 5.0 Ford right there?
That's a 5.0 with a 302 cubic inch. And Steve Stewart, Bruce Hanley behind the wheel. That's Chris Perry and the Perry Antique sponsor number 41 machine from letting them make this way out. Jim Gilbert from the St. Clair area and the WIL 92 FM machine. Randy Besser in the Saloon Photos number 24 car from down in Branson, Missouri. And Mike Aiken in the Aiken Racing 01 late model stock division car. David Rich out of Springfield in the Affordable
Vince Company sponsor Double Zero, the Bomb Squad Division, and with Big Daddy's Restaurant and Lowell Morgan Construction on Brian Brown's number two Super Soccer. Larry Pruitt in the Pruitt Racing 02 machine. Ben Newell in the Custom Concrete number 83 late model stock division car. McCann Printing on the side of Linda Craig's number 20 Bomb Squad. And Willie Compton with the complete auto towing sponsor 04. Mike Benson in the CarQuest number 23 machine. And Dave Anderson in the Anderson's One Stop number 4 machine. Sight and Sound and Johnson's Racing Enterprises on the number 22 car of Scotty Atkinson, and Weber Excavating out of Rolla, Missouri on Rick Oliver's number 12, the Bomb Squad Division. Bill's Refrigeration on Randy Nutter's number 3 machine makes its way out, along with George Huey in the D&W's place, number 41. I don't trust you. A and B, do what? What do you want? Touch. Jesse Hawkins in car 06 makes it out in the German Brown Trout machine, along with Jerry Foster in the number 15, the DJ Sporting Package car. Archie Griffin, the BND Auto and Truck Class sponsorship number 11 car, and the AutoZone sponsor number 34 car of the Joma from Crawford, Jim Hayes. Second stage sponsorship on car number 97, Troy Constable, and the Exclamate sponsorship number 64 of Mark Chan. Steve Holt in the McCann Printing Brothers Auto and Diesel number 35 machine. Makes the way out also. I'm going to get you later, you know that. As Chief Stewart Bruce Hanley, bring him down on the front stretch to park down here. And Bob, we've got a great deal for our parade of sponsors. All five divisions running are very. You know what? You're not going to insert the muscle down there, are you? Shake hands and make friends. How about that? You know what? A great car count in all five divisions, Ronnie. And I tell you what, we are going to have ourselves one well programmed this evening. You heard the number a little while ago. The biggest late model car count all year long, including the Art Show show. We start at 24. There are 20 late models jacked in for tonight's big 40-lap main event. Of course, don't forget the rule of the track. If you win the feature 1 week, you start shotguns the next week. So the driver's side is shotgun the saving or tailback in the main event. Speedo, are you driving traffic down there? You're sending it the wrong way. I'd be careful down there. You win 1 week, you start shotgun the next. So the driver's starting tailback in the late model main event. We'll have 19 cars to go through in order to get to the front of the field. That's an awful lot of traffic here trying to get through. Start the program off with the super stock, go through the modified, the late model stock, the late model heat races. Then the bomb squad will have their chance on the track. We'll take a brief intermission break. Of course, Speedo will be on hand to sign his autograph. A whole lot of race fans. And then the second half of the program with all five huge features. And next week will be a big one. Giveaway night at the Friday Night Action Track, Speedway USA, and the Sweet Auto Sales night here at the I-44 Speedway. I tell you what, Bob, Speedo's gotten real popular with the businesses. Speedo compliments the DTC custom design and silk screening. And your first time down here and already you made friends.
Hey, I love you people here. You people have been so good to DTC. Get me a beautiful little camp here. It says Speedo Incorporated. Now, isn't that really nice? Look at that. I think that's just dandy. Thank you, ETC Screen Printing.
And I believe, Bob, if you're ready topside, we're just about ready to get things underway.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as we do each and every Saturday evening at this time, we invite you to please rise for our pre-race invocation and remain standing for our national anthem. And here with us for the first time this year, representing Raceway Ministries, is Frank Stark.
Let us bow our heads and go to the Lord in prayer. Our Father in God, as we bow in your presence tonight, we want to thank you for this beautiful race tonight. Thank you for the beautiful field of cars that we have to race. We ask for safety for everyone who's involved in tonight's activities. Thank you for the great nation that we live in where events like this can be held. And our Father, we pray that even now as we make our plans to attend the church of our choice tomorrow, to worship Jesus Christ in spirit and in truth, thank you most of all for your Son Jesus, for his life, death, burial, and resurrection, and through him we can all be winners. For we ask in the name of Jesus and for his sake. Amen.
Last weekend we celebrated our nation's birthday. Please remain standing for tonight's national anthem.
Hey, he's a clown. Come here. That was a nice job that Rosie and the car did.
Well, I think it was pretty nice. All I have to do is just turn this little wheel here, and Rosie just does her tricks.
What are you going to do for us tonight?
What am I going to do for you tonight?
What are you going to do for the crowd tonight?
I'm going to...
How about that?
I'm going to come out here, and we're going to put on a little comedy car act after you've run a few heats. And then we're going to come back, and my sister's going to be here. My sister's Speed Arena is... Slap you in a minute. My sister Speed Arena is going to come out here, and she's going to attempt a track record right out here on the speedway with the rockets on the back of the clown car.
Well, that sounds good, but what do you think we ought to do right now?
I think we ought to crank them up and let's go racing!
What do you think of the grandstand? Are you ready to go racing?
Bob is our first qualifying heat of the evening in the Super Stock division. Will now be rolling out. Chuck Richards will lead him out from down in Wadeville in car number 41. Rick Montgomery from Urbana, Missouri in car number 47. Jim Case had a fair play in the number 91 car in Lebanon's Mike Daddy in car number 16. Roger Gillum from up in Rolla, Missouri in car number 37. And Ron Myers from Lebanon in car number 11. Sam Shaw from Rogersville driving the number 81 machine this evening. As we see Tony Fincher in car number 17, Kim Stark, who just barely made it here this evening in car number 52. And back with us, the defending Super Stock champion from down in Millen, Missouri. That, of course, Sergeant Charlie Johnson in car number 1. And Bob, if we can get the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard lit up, we'll get everybody up into position here and just about set to go. As Mr. Foreman shows them that rolled up green flag, this is the first qualifier you need to try to finish within the top six of your qualifying heat to get on the average board. But remember, one driver, Troy Costa, or not Troy Costa, but Steve Edgecombe, thinking of last night, he will be starting dead last in the Super Stock feature. Richards and Montgomery in the front row as they go into turn three, or known as Calamity Corner. The lights are on, Keith has the greens rolled up, and no.
Time and he's going to drop the caution flag. We'll get it lined up in their original position.
Wasn't so much when they lined up as they were trying on the restart, Bob. And he felt that was a little bit of what we would call a ragged start. So we'll get them back up. Original restart. Let's try this one more time. We'll get Richards up on the front row along with Rick Montgomery. These cars are lined up on a point average system. It's how they are lined up. They don't draw except during special events. There we go. Case and Daddy. Then we'll get Gillum along with Stark, Shaw and Myers. The Herb Pickard machine along with Charlie Johnson. Tony Fincher will be starting back toward the rear in car number 17. If you miss 2 point shows back to back, you lose your point average. That means the heat race, you have to start at the rear. And Rick Montgomery falling off the pace just a little bit for Urbana, Missouri driver. Nice and easy. Richards now will start to pick it up just a little bit down the back stretch. Here they come. The lights are off. Keith rocks them over and the green flag is out and we're going to go racing. Richards and Montgomery now quickly, and here comes Jim Case, one of the most improved drivers in that Super Stock. Oh, as Case and Richards get together, and Shaw takes a wild ride to avoid him. And that's going to bring out the yellow flag. And Bob, a great job by all the drivers avoiding the spinning car of Jim Case.
You know, that's a pat on the back to each and every one of the drivers, Ronnie, because when you see it spin near the front of the field, you look at the possibility of taking in and maybe taking out about eight cars or so. But it looks like after that spin, we're not going to lose anyone whatsoever. So we're going to line them up. And you look at the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard, it will be an original side-by-side and nose-to-tail restart as we turn them loose for the eighth-lap qualifier for the Super Stock. Well, as you are heading through the Richland area, a number of folks you can contact, we invite you to stop by and see Brown's Caldwell Oil, located in Richland. The great folks, and boy, you know what, you want to hear about any bigger racing fan. Find folks at Caldwell Oil, and Ronnie, the lights will go off.
Oh, that's right. And of that bus has come out. Richard Montgomery once again, along with Gillum and Shaddy. Charlie Storm, once Ron Meyer, and then of course Charlie Johnson back with us. They've worked for the last 3 weeks to get this brand new car ready. Here they come, and they say the third time's a charm. The green is out. We're back to race and action. And Rick Montgomery takes the early lead in car number 47 at the green light into turn number two now. Starts the one Gillum in another 37 machine. Down through Calamity Corner, Montgomery sets the pace. Side by side, they come off turn of the board. Stark in no man's land as they're trying it 2 and 3 deep. As Gillum now moves up to that number two spot. Shaw now making his charging call. Oh, as Stark is into Shaddy. Shaddy's into Richards, and Richards head on into the wild side area. Chuck Richards getting head on off of turn number two. And Bob, they were going bender bender in that time. All of them going for that third place position. But you know what, Ryan? That car got completely airborne. A couple of feet off the air, came down and very close to rolling and then smacked the wall. Richards, though, appears to be all right as that car has been backed up right near the white line above the track. That was absolutely unbelievable the way you saw that car leave here, almost like it had wings on it. But boy, that was a wild ride. You see all kinds of contact a little bit early on as cars will be lined up with a lap down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. And you see Richards climbing out of that number 41 machine after a wild, wild ride. And Ronnie, theoretically, the doors aren't supposed to work on these cars, but the passenger door even popped open. That'll show you how hard of an impact there was that time. Well, when you're looking for all your course information, either 5 o'clock in the evening or at 10 o'clock, please tune cable channel 8 or KSBR channel 33. Good friend of mine, Jerry Jacobs, will pass along all the local, regional, and national results. KSBR channel 33 in Springfield. And for rock of all ages, classic rock and roll from the 70s and 80s, B95 in Springfield. That's 95.5 on your FM dial. Boy, Richards is going to be taken back to the pit area in that car number 41 after crazy ride this evening, right in between turns 1 and 2. And he'll take advantage under this red flag situation to get the field lined up in the proper spot with a lap down and 7 laps remaining on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Fast car qualifier for the Super Stock is in the staging area and will hit the track next. Our chief steward, Bruce Hanley, will make sure that there is no debris on the track following that contact. Now the red light is turned off. Caution is back on. The field will start to roll. This will be a nose-to-tail restart, not an original restart. Also great to have with us Jim's Professional Auto Repair on Highway 54 in Osage Beach. Just blocked down the lane, road 54, 56. They'll work on imports or domestic. And repairs and prices you can afford. Jim's Professional Auto Repair in Osage Beach. Lap down, 7 laps remaining on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Not all that long. We know the Speedway Clown will be back on the track with us. And a little bit later on tonight, Speed Arena. Speedo's good-looking sister is going to be out with us, trying to set a brand new track record for the fastest time down the front straightaway. Also got some giveaways for you this evening. McLeod Auto Sales Racing Chance, and from the Chance Anderson Racing Team, we've also got a t-shirt to pass out. Everyone lined up in the proper position with 7 laps remaining on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard.
Well, that's right, Bob. 1 lap down and Rick Montgomery, your pace hitter, Gillum right on his bumper, Shaddy running third.
Stars holds on the fourth, Stars running fifth. Myers in the bubble spot, running in sixth right now in car number seven. Montgomery starts to pick up the pace quickly in the 47 machine. Here they come with that green flag back out, and we're back to a race of action. And Rod Myers taking a hard charge along with Jim Cate. Cate pushes to the, now moving up through the pack. But meanwhile in the Calamity Corner is Gillum and Montgomery side by side. And they come off turn four. Montgomery gets up in no man's land. And now Roger Gillum goes to the lead in car number 37. It's Gillum one, Montgomery two, and here comes Tim Thorpe. Tim Thorpe in that Pontiac Grand Prix on the charge now in the number 52 machine. And here comes Ron Myers in car number 11. Oh, that's Roger Charlie up by the auto air and audio sign. In car number one, takes a wild ride on the wild side.
He's been off for a couple of weeks, Ronnie, after being involved in a major incident at the Speedway, and that's his second wild ride during the first qualifier for the Superstock. Getting up close and personal with Auto Air and Audio's billboard sign, and it swung it down a couple, spun it around, it's past B95 and the Springfield engine supply sign, charging Charlie Johnson in car number one out of Miller. Boy, that was another crazy ride. He's faced in the wrong direction right now, and that's the last thing that he and the Johnson Racing team wanted to see after having to take a couple of weeks off because of all the damage done to that number one machine.
His car was virtually destroyed about 3 weeks ago over at Speedway USA in Bolivar. They've been out since then. They've got the double donut car of Ramey back. They got the 00 superstocker of Robbie, who is third in the point standings back. And Charlie went into the nice action, still in the top five. So we're going to see if the Wonder Crew from down in Miller will be able to get to the Bending Track champion back out in time for the feature this evening.
Hopefully, just a lot of aesthetic damage to that number one machine. And Ronnie, you can see all the work that the crews had to do just to get Charlie back onto the track. They haven't even had an opportunity to put the final paint job on it. But you notice, and you and I talked about this earlier, you look at the Johnson Racing team, not difficult to spot them, Ronnie, an awful lot of orange.
That's right. Of course, Bob, as we said, Roger Gillum has taken over the number 37 car from Rolla here all a couple, 2 or 3 weeks ago. He is your pace setter. Rick Montgomery running second, Stark is third, Ron Myers fourth, Jim Case is fifth, and Scott Baruth. As this car normally driven by Herb Sickers, but because of job hours, let's put it that way, Scott Baruth, who debuted here last week in that Marlin Oil Company machine out of Springfield, he is now on what we call the bubble spot, because you need to try to finish in the top six if we've got two heat races to get with what we call the 12-car inversion. And Bob, every one of the feature winners from last week, did they ever dream we were going to have over 100 cars in the pits here this season? Gillum, your leader, Montgomery is second. Stark third, Myers fourth, Case fifth, Garut on the bubble. Two laps are down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. And of course, we mentioned Bob last Friday, or tomorrow, next Friday night, over at Speedway USA Bolivar. The late model stops will be on hand. And with them sitting out last night, they're going to get to run for some extra cash and some extra laps.
Next Friday night at Bolivar Speedway USA.
We've been alternating them in the late model stops. And Mr. Richard Huddy will be heading back down here below the I-44 welcoming board. And she's had that green flag rolled up. Gillum and Montgomery. Stark and Myers, Case and Baruth, those are the six you want to watch right now, because if they're trying to get in within that inversion to finish within the top six rows for tonight's big A feature. The lights go off around the high bank to the 11 to 944 Speedway, with Roger Gillum to set the pace. Watch Montgomery glued to his bumper. But Stark and Ron Myers have quickly been coming through the pack. Here they come, and the green is out, and we're back to race of action. Watch Stark and Myers. Wheel to wheel they go for the number three spot. Will they take over Montgomery in that runner-up spot while Roger Gillum Gillum continues to set the pace. Side by side into Calamity Corner now. Tires shooting down to the low side. Montgomery once again in what we call no man's land. Oh! A super soft sandwich. And Tim Storm beating the meat of that sandwich as Montgomery now falls well off the pace. Hey, Tim Storm now continue to go wheel to wheel. And now your leader, Roger Gillum, still in control. Myers is up to the number two spot. And what Jim Chase. Chase now up to third. Stark is fourth. The route fifth. Montgomery now running sixth. While Gillum has a comfortable lead. It looks like he might be slowing up just a little bit on the back stretch. That now Kate starts to reel in. Jumps on fire. Stalk and Garou continue to fight it out back there for fourth and fifth. As Gillum completes another lap in the leader. Now watch Kate trying to set Ron Myers up. Garou dives to the low side of Star. It's the Ford versus the Pontiac battle for position. Myers going by the wild side. Just a little bit high. As your leader comes off. Down the front straightaway. It's still Roger Gillum. But watch Myers and Kate now. As Garou tries to make the move on Star. The battle now for second, third, along with fourth and fifth. Storm gets up in the gray area of the marble and the race now for the runner-up spot. And Dan or Roger Gillum will come out third number four in the white flag. Only one more lap to go. Tate and Myers continue their battle for the number two and three spots. That's the route now out for Storm running thin. Watch the race for the number two place. But right now from Rolla, Missouri, it's going to be all Roger Gillum as he roars down the front straightaway, taking the checkered flag. Chase comes off second, Myers is third, Garou fourth, Stark finishing. It's really been strong the last couple of weeks at Speedway USA in car number two. A former bomb squad champion from last year, Chris Nichols, moving up a class this year in car number 10. Tim McCallum from Buffalo in the number 12 car. Wayne Lewis in 14. Remnant's Mike Paul in car number 4. Last week's feature winner. He'll start shotgun tonight. That, of course, the gentleman we call the English gentleman, Steve Edgecombe, in car number 65. Remember, no points awarded in the heat races. And he sure wishes they was right now as your point leader from Rolla, driving car 97, Troy Constable. Also making his way up from St. James, Missouri, in the number 42 car, second in the standing, Tom Klaus. Back at the rear in the double donut machine, third in the track point standing from Miller, last year's rookie of the year, Robbie Johnson. And rounding out this 10-car qualifier, out of Springfield, Missouri, car number 33, Darrell Butcher. The Lebanon gang, as they call themselves, Brown and Nichols, take it very easily. The lights are off as they start to pick up the pace. Keith looks the field over. The green is out and we're back to race and action. It doesn't matter where Edgecombe finishes in the heat. He's starting dead last in the feature. But wheel to wheel, a couple of young soldiers from London. Nichols and Brown go out, and here comes McCowan along with Edgecombe. Johnson and Paul also in this great train. Coming down the front stretch for lap number one, it's Chris Nichols setting the pace. And here comes Edgecombe. Edgecombe and Paul, but now Tim McCowan makes a move on the high side. And the McCowan trucking sponsor number 12 car from down in Buffalo, Missouri. Trying to run down to Lebanon, Georgia, Chris Nichols as Robbie Johnson starts to fall off the pace. Two laps are now down. Two down, six to go. Nichols, your leader, has watched the battle for second right now between McCowan and Edgecombe. Nose to tail, watch Edgecombe. He likes that low groove off the Calamity Corner especially. Nichols, once again, still setting up for three pace. McCowan and Edgecombe going wheel to wheel for second place. Constable running fourth, Brown is fifth, Klaus running sixth on the bubble. Ryan Lewis with problems at car 14 as they go wheel to wheel for the number two spot. It's still Nichols out in front looking for his first ever super soft heat race win. Edgecombe now trying to make the front center pass on McCowan and does it. McCowan opting for the high side as the English gentleman is now on the charge. Edgecombe trying to run down a leading contender for rookie of the year here at the I-44 Speedway. But here comes McCowan back on last week's winner. Why, your point leader, Troy Costabella, is coming on strong. It's a four-car train as Klaus now trying to close up. Nichols, Wallace takes it to the corner. Here comes Edgecombe down low in the Calamity Corner, trying to get the nose down low. Nichols shuts the door as they come down for lap number six, the lap car of Butcher now. In a sportsman-like manner, pulled down low. But watch Costabella, your track point leader, Troy Costabella.
Maximum is on the move. He now takes over third spot. He's working on the edge home for another two spot. The white flag is coming out. That's on the round for the Lebanon chauffeur, Chris Nichols, and he's only got one more left to go. Nichols pulls away by three car lengths. It's Cole Constable, McCowan, and Klaus to top five. As they roar down the backstretch, it's Cole. Will he use that familiar road for his pass? Nichols driving right in the fast lane. As they roar down the front straightaway, it's Nichols with the victory. It's Cole second, Constable third, McCowan fourth, Klaus fifth, Brown sixth, and Mike Hall. Bob, the Super Streak feature is going to be a dandy. Is Andy Dan the Wizard Photographer man down here to take action shots? And Bob, give us that starting grid for the first qualifier.
Caroline Henson and Heather Inman. Caroline Henson and Heather Inman jump to the tower.
Here is the starting grid for tonight's first qualifier for the Grand American Modified. Donna Fairgirl, Terry Taylor, former Super Stock driver in car 66, leads the way. Roy Roberts in car 90.
Joe Tireshop, the supporter of car 22, and the driver, John Corwin. Out of Kansas in car 21. He brings a huge fan following with him. That's Brian Marler. Last night's feature winner at the Friday Night Action Track. And oh, was there some enthusiasm in the winner's circle for Lee McGill, the chauffeur behind the wheel of car 10. The lights go off around the high banks of the I-44 Speedway. Hang on to those tickets, Duff. We've got a giveaway coming up in a couple of minutes. Eight times around. Keith Foreman looks over the field, and he will say, let's go racing! Taylor falls to the lead, and Marler on the high side. Two wins by Roberts, and up to the number two position. On the back stretch, and Chris Rockport in car one, part of the Gateway Connection, makes it out of Bentley. Donnie Jumper in car 75 leads out the field. Russell Graves in 73. The double donut modified of Ramey Johnson from Miller. Brian Kamika's had a long and a strong run recently in car 5. And the track points leader, David Mason, 91. Starting outside row one in the fast car qualifier as they make their way down the backstretch. It's Jumper, Graves, Johnson, Kapinka, and Bates. Eight times around the open wheel thunder and lightning slowly in the Calamity Corner. Dean Foreman's going to look over the field, and he will say this time around, let's go! I think Ronnie might have brought that shotgun with him to make sure Speedo doesn't get anywhere near him. Boy, he's with us, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for Speedo, the Speedway Clown. Hey, Rosie's got a mind of her own, though, that Ford. Speedo, the car's moving. You're not even in it. Oh, my. You better be a little bit quicker than that if you want to hop aboard, Speedo. We know who's in charge down there, and I don't think it's the clown. Oh, it looks like you might have some problems. Speedo, I think that car's got some problems. That didn't feel too good, did it? There you go. Shut that one. Uh-oh. Look around back. I think the water's shooting back there. Now it's coming out the front again, Speedo. You can't seem to get this car under control, can you? There you go. Maybe that'll take care of it. Oh, boy, that didn't sound good. The Gatorade didn't solve it. You weren't able to plug the leaks. What now? Maybe you got some engine problems. Open up that hood and see what kind of problems you got underneath there. Oh, you got to try and start her first. There you go. Now she's all fired up. Rosie's ready to go. Climb aboard. Rosie doesn't want to go, Speedo. I told you that car's got a mind of its own. It's running the show this evening, not you. Might want to check the oil. Oh, my, what is that smell? That smells terrible. You better look inside that engine and see what the problem is. A skunk? How in the world did that get in there with you? Did you bring that all the way from the south? Oh, boy. You had to do it, didn't you? Throw that thing away. You got anything else in there that's giving you problems? Check that oil. That is the longest dipstick I have seen in a long time. Uh-oh. Is that your Speedo? Speedo, is that your bra? Are you sure? Is it hers? Or is it Kathy? It's David? Now let's see if you can't get that car taken care of. You better give your mechanic a call there. Oh, he's going to call you back. Okay. Speedo. What is that? Kids, what? Is that the phone ringing? Boy, that's his mechanic calling back. Hey, fans, one time, what do you think? Did Speedo get up and answer that phone and hear from his mechanic? Let me hear you nice and loud one time. Did Speedo get up and answer that phone? Even the phone shooting water out at you, Speedo. Oh, boy. You had the engine working. Now you got the flat tire. Can you solve that problem for us? You got the Ford from Bolivar at 11, and now you got a flat tire. You better pump that thing up. There you go. Go ahead and pump it up. Uh-oh. Hey, Speedo. Turn around. Turn around, Speedo. Look behind you. It moved. That car's got a mind of its own. I don't know how you're going to pump it up if it keeps moving like that. Car's shaking, his headlights no. Who's in charge out here anyway? You know, Rosie's in charge. You better teach that car a lesson. Go ahead, take it here. It's coming after you now. Okay, now I think it's ready to have that right front pumped up. Uh-oh, Speedo, you're pumping up the wrong tire. Look at the rear tires there, fans. Speedo, it's the wrong tire. You are pumping up the wrong tire. He doesn't believe me. I think he's about to learn a lesson. Speedo's not listening to me. He thinks he's pumping up the right tire. Whoa! You're going to listen to me next time, aren't you, Speedo? Well, we got a little air in that right front. We see the Rosie's in charge, not Speedo. You better belt that car a couple good times. Show it exactly who's in charge. You're liable to make... Oh, you made it angry now, Speedo. You made that car angry. You're in a whole lot of trouble. It's coming right after you. And I bet it may even shoot you. Yeah, there it goes. You done picked on it a little bit too much. Now you're in trouble. We're going to need the freak paramedics to take care of you. Ow! Boy, that's one sore backside.
Ladies and gentlemen, what do you say one time? Speedo, the Speedway Clown. He's going to be back with us periodically throughout the evening, signing autographs during intermission. Speed Arena is going to be also with us, trying to set a brand new track record with the fastest time down the straightaway. And Rosie, that old Model A Ford, will also be back on hand. And Speedo said he may even take it through the wild side. Late model stock heat race. Please head out of the pit, out of the staging area, and onto the track. Well, down the front stretch, fans, what do you say? Speedo, the Speedway Clown. Hey, Speedo, watch out. You're about to run into a heat race. Late model stock, first heat. Please head out of the... Also headed out on a track of damage during a heat race, but Mike Aiken has made it out of the 0-1 machine. The Bjork Regal of Milton and Johnny Atkinson, car 22. Chris Perry in car 41. Gentlemen, Jim Gilbert in car 6. Sam Payne out of Buffalo in car 49. The 65 machine of Lebanon, Tim Jackson. Also headed out onto the track, Randy Lester in car 24. And out of Camden, Ben Newell in car 83.
Of course, the NASCAR rule indicates that if you are either involved in
or cause a spin, you go tailback. And
a little bit of rustic car number 4.
McDaniel and Jim Hayes in the Crocker area in car 34. Boy, not good news at all for either one of those drivers, especially Jack Daniel, who's involved in a tight point battle in that number one machine. We'll bring the field to a stop down the backstretch. Boy, there must be something about the backstretch this evening, Ronnie. That is the third accident already involving cars down the backstretch.
And Bob, I believe the Reverend is all right in the number one car. As you can see, the driver's side right up against that quality Ford sign as they were going off on the pit area. And Jim Hayes, a severe front end damage to his Ford Thunderbird from down in Crocker, Missouri. And fans, definitely, it's going to put a big impact on the point standing. Right now, about how we're going to get is your second heater on the wall side. Right there for the racing Reverend Jack Daniel and the gentleman from Crocker, Jim Hayes.
Boys, both will be shown back to the pit area, and hopefully they're going to be able to make the bell for our main event this evening, Ronnie. And, you know, a lot of fine folks up to make the racing competition possible on this level. The Boatman's Bank of Pulaski County is just one of those fine organizations. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow, they can handle all your banking needs. Boatman's Bank of Pulaski County, or if you're in the Lebanon area, and you want to stay right at home, the Central Bank of Lebanon can handle all your needs, both as far as business is concerned and personally as well. That is the Central Bank, also with a location in Conway, set to serve the great racing fans. That, of course, is the Central Bank. And as you're driving to the highway, I know a lot of our friends from Camp attended to go through Lebanon stop there. Get-Go, located at the corner of Jefferson and Highway 5 in Lebanon. If you want to fuel up, Monica Knight, Google Ozark Coca-Cola. They are the fine folks to contact. Get-Go. Locations all across southwest and south central Missouri. You can find them on just about every street corner or so. Ronnie, I got to ask you something. What about the backstretch? Get all of the experience behind the windshield in the late model stock division. Two-time Speedway champion Bill Gillum. Three-time Speedway USA champion Larry Roberts. And the veteran out of Camden, J.C. Newell.
Bob, this, without a doubt, one of the funnest classes that there is to watch. You've got a lot of good jokers, a lot of good talent behind the wheel of an automobile. Now, we talked to several of the drivers in the winner's circle. They'll tell you, that restrictor plate puts the driver ability back into the car. They have to work on that chassis even harder. Now, they are restricted to a little bit from what they can do with the motor. That restrictor plate does not allow a whole bunch of air coming down through the carburetor. Therefore, the Super Street and these cars are almost similar to late models that look like. They have what they call a stock sub front end. Very similar to what you can get in the salvage yard also. They weigh 3,100 pounds. That's the minimum weight they can weigh when they cross the scales in this late model stock division. Bob, this is a very fun class, very affordable class, but it is also a very fast class because of that restrictor plate. You've got to have a pretty good motor underneath the hood, but you've also got to be able to be a good chassis man. And right here, we've got some of the finest chassis drivers that you'll find anywhere in the Fort Saint area.
Ronnie, we're now looking for another ticket, and go ahead and pass out one of the little photo certificates courtesy of Randy Besser. Looking for ticket number 66691. All out those ticket stubs, 66691. We've got that coming to the tower, 66691.
Here we go, Bob. The lights are off. One down, seven to go in the fast dash. He still quickly goes through the gears in that orange Pomerito Chevrolet Lumina. As the green comes back out, we're at the race in action. Watch the battle for second, third, fourth, and fifth. No points are in the heat races. But here they go as Roberts has the gentle giant duel right on his bumper. Your point-leader Lawrence and Marchand going at it also. But it's still Bill Gillum setting the pace. Gillum out of Steelville, Missouri. He's got the veteran Lawrence Roberts right behind him on car number 10. Bobby Mendy in the 41 car. Brian Daniel in 52. Tim Swearingen in car 14. Steve Simmons of Springfield is 19. 18 years old. And he's now in his second race as a late model rookie. That is Jamie McMurray in car number 30. John O'Neill from Victor in 22.
want to be on hand for giveaway night. Extra laps, extra cash for the Grand American late model stock car.
Back with us in car number 13, Reverend Tennis, Todd Dickinson in car number 21, and the Richland Bullet, Bob Webster in 25. Joe Walsh out of Fenton, Missouri, former modified champion, back with us in car 99, and second in the track point standing, Springfield's Archie Griffin in car number 11. He will start shot 10 tonight, no matter what he does in the heat, man. Your current point leader in car 75, Larry Phillips. Back also with us from California, Missouri, only his second year on the asphalt in the 0-2 car, Greg Robertson. And starting shotgun, keep your eyes on this young man from Walnut Grove, Missouri. He's a regular at the Friday Night Action Track in car 04, Jerry Kelly. Nine cars settling down for 10 laps of exciting late model bumper-to-bumper action. Top six trying to qualify the immersion. Doesn't matter where Larry finishes that heat with last week's winner. He'll start dead last as they slowly go into Calamity Corner. Here's up the veteran now to start to set the pace. Here they come. And the green is out. Let's go.
for.
Curtis.
Uh-oh. Vito has left us. Who is that? That flaming red hair? Could that be Fiorina? That is Vito's good-looking sister. But the problem is they look identical. Ladies and gentlemen, her first appearance at the I-44 Speedway. What do you think? Make her feel welcome. This is Fiorina. She is going to try and set a brand new track record. Yeah, adjust everything. You got luck. Yep, everything is just wiggle that cute one. Hey, the flagman's staring at you again, Fiorina. Now, Keith, I thought you had a fill of that last night. You don't need to be looking down that dress. Is someone up there looking down that dress, too? You better safety check that car before you head down the front straightaway. Make sure everything is in its proper position. Check the left side tires. How about those rocket engines back there? Don't get too close. Oh, the lights work up there. Is the roll cage, how about that right rear tire? Is that ready? You gonna kick that right front? Uh-oh. Someone's staring at you again, Fiorina. I think it's that guy in the front row. Whoa! I think you might be in trouble. That car shot something at you that time. Think you might be on fire, Fiorina. You need some help. That backside's on fire, Fiorina. Oh, there we go. You better thank your rescuer, too. Woo! Is that a match made in heaven? Did that shake you up, too? Dave hasn't had a kiss like that in a long time. All right, now you need the safety equipment if you're going to set this brand new track record. You went to the best safety store. You better take off that hair. Got that number one safety helmet. Got those gloves that are only 50 years old. Make sure everything's adjusted properly. Yeah, he's doing it again. He needs a scolding. He's not getting his Chauncey's ice cream tonight. All right, are you ready for us, Fiorina? Strap yourselves in. Vance, what do you think? Can Fiorina set a brand new track record this evening? What do you think? All right. Let's get all strapped in there and get this show on the road. There we go. Oh, boy. You're going the wrong way. Might have lost the engine again. Fiorina, you got to go the other way. That car's got a mind of its own. Rosie's not listening to you. She wants to go the other way. Now she's ready to go. Okay, we're going straight this time. But I think Fiorina might need a little bit of help. A brand new Speedway track record. Nice and loud one time. Can Fiorina set the track record tonight, fans? What do you think? Wild time. Let's get those horns and lights going for Fiorina. All right, the engines are firing. Head on out for that track record. There. Oh, down the front straightaway. Got those stopwatches going. Blew again, Fiorina. The engine blew. You're going to have to try and refire that engine somehow. I'd take a couple punches at that Ford. You might have to light those engines yourself. They just don't want to seem to stay fired for you. You got it under control? Matches to a rocket engine? That's not real. Oh, ouch. That's not real smart. Try it again. See if you can't fire them up. Didn't blow up on you that time.
There! It's leaving you! Oh, my goodness! Fiorina, the naked Speedway clown! This
didn't work last night, didn't get a new track record at the Friday Night Action Track. I don't think we're going to get one this evening. Boy, nothing's working for Speed Arena tonight. Take that car below the white line. A little bit frustrated, knocking the flags down, half naked. Speed Arena, you look a little bit dejected down there. So frustrated, Speed Arena's gonna have to try and disappear. I tell you what, she tried to put on a great show for us this evening, but a little bit dejected. Speed Arena wasn't able to set the track record this evening either. So the good-looking sister of Speedo, Speed Arena, is going to get tied up in that black case. And we're going to cover her up, and she's just going to disappear to back wherever Speed Arena, the Speedway clown, came from. Tell you what, Kathy's going to tie her up in there nice and tight. Hey, hands off. Hands off. She's engaged. Okay, Speed Arena's all tied up inside there, and boy, this has not been Speed Arena's night. Sorry you couldn't come through for us tonight, Speed Arena. You come a long, long way to be with us. So go and cover Speed Arena up, cover that forward up, nicknamed as Rosie. Boy, this has not been the night for, this has not been the weekend for Speed Arena. Very disappointed. She's very dejected. Wasn't able to come through for all the great racing fans in the Ozarks. You know, I talked to Speedo and Speed Arena earlier tonight, told them what great racing fans we had in the Ozarks and how enthusiastic they were. And boy, she was all excited about trying to set the brand new track record this evening, but it just never happened. That Ford had a mind of its own this evening. It wanted to go backwards, and then when it did go forwards, it blew out the engine. So Speed Arena decided just to go ahead and leave us this evening underneath that tarp. Boy, she's going back to wherever Speed Arena came from. I don't know about you fans, but I'd like to see Speed Arena, the good-looking sister of Speedo, back. What do you say? With your applause, we may be able to bring Speed Arena back. What do you say? One time, nice and loud, grandstands in the wild side, get the horns, get the lights working. Let's bring back Speed Arena, the Speedway Clown. How about some of those horns on the wild side? Let's see the good-looking sister of Speedo. Tried to disappear, but will she come up? Woo! Fans, Speed Arena, the good-looking sister of Speedo, the Speedway Clown. Boy, that's quite a change. Keep forming, keep your eyes back in your head. Hey, who else is in there? Who else is in there? Speedo! Speedo, welcome back! There we go. What do you say, ladies and gentlemen, for Speed Arena and Speedway, the Speedway Clown? Boy, I tell you what, they put on a great show. They're going to be up here signing autographs during intermission for us. Got some glossies on sale. Make them feel welcome in the Ozark. Speedo and Speed Arena, the Speedway Clown. Patrick Smith and Samantha Holm, please come to the tower, please. Boy, down on the wild side. Speedo may even take a trip up there before all is said and done this evening. Hey, wild side, how about the horns? How about the lights for the Speedway Clown? Boy, they want a party with you, say, there we go. Got some of those lights working. We got the horns over there. It's a something like Speedo and Speed Arena have never experienced it. Boy, they've been across the country, but they love the wild side. And speaking of wild, speaking of crazy, they are ready to roll out of the pit. What do you say, Bob Woody? Send them on out. Here comes the first heat for what's known as the grassroots of area racing. They are going to roll out. Anyway, Ford are coming out at full throttle, making their way down the front stretch first. I was wrong. We're going three qualifiers this evening for the bomb squad. They come out in full force. Mark Wood leading them out of car 26 to 94. John Galt, Darren Weaver in car 7. The big 28 of Mike McMoe. Now Yarbrough in car 1. Randall Weddle in 32. Lead the Holiday in car 18 to 64. Driven by Carl Smith. Paul Phillips in car 17. And behind the wheel of car 90 this evening. Stretch the cup. The green flag is in the air. What a Weaver on the pole. Thompson Weddle in row number 2. McMullen and Holiday. Yarbrough and Phillips. Wood will take him into Calamity Corner. Keith Foreman looks over the field and we'll say this. Time around. Let's go. Five quad racing. As they both head to the rear of the field. Two laps down. And on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard, four laps remaining. Well, after the race, why did you visit Big Daddy's Family Restaurant at exit 127 off I-44-11, the biggest sign off the interstate. This portion of the state. Matter of fact, that nice car show there earlier today, and Speedo was on hand. Understand a lot of that great chicken was served as well at Big Daddy's Family Restaurant. And fans and youngsters especially, during the intermission break, Speedo, the Speedway Clown, is going to be up in the grandstand right below the tower, I believe, or right behind the tower, signing some autographs. He'll sign anything if you want him to. And we'll also have the gorgeous colored glossies on sale for only a couple of bucks. T-shirts are also on sale this evening for all the racing fans. We've also got some giveaways for you during intermission this evening. Lineup appears to be a good one. With two laps down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Want to get the field bunched up though as they are led by Al Yarbrough. Now the lights go off. Leads it down the back stretch. And now, oh boy, that's not a pretty sight. All kinds of smoke out of the machine of Carl Smith. It looks like that engine has let loose all kinds of fluid on the track. Richard Putty, fresh off his charter flight from New Hampshire, can have to let a lot of quick dry loose on the track. So you know what that means, man. Haul out those ticket stubs. Brake check. All out those 6 and 7s. We got some of the racing hats from Willard Hoffman, a great friend of McLeod Auto Sales, passed out. Ticket number 58239. 58239. We also have another racing hat from McLeod Auto Sales to pass out to you. And this, that George, that is Tower, will be happy to give that out to you. The lights go off. Two down, four remaining on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Yarbrough leads it down the back stretch. Woods, McMullen, Weaver, Phillips, Willie Thompson. By Cleo Jasper's 93, Mike Benson in car number 23. Terry Holtkamp in car 2, Roy Hanson in 24, Linda Cranks 20, Rick Oliver in car 12, Chris Shoemaker in car 21, Daniel Graves in 66. New with us this week, Richard Beyer in car 54, Jason Woods in car 92. Fast car qualifier for the bomb squad is in the staging area. As we make sure that all the debris and the moisture is taken care of in turn number two. Down the front stretch they come.
Bob wanted to remind the people the 50-50 raffle tickets are also on sale back there toward the souvenir stand. And I think they can get you at that little booth over there on the wild side. When it is a dollar a chance, it's kind of like a lottery. You can play the Speedway. 50 cents out of each dollar goes towards the kitty for the night. The other 50 cents out of every dollar will go also towards the driver's award banquet, son. And Bob, the lights are off. Here we go.
Cleo Jasper set in the paint. Let's go. Bomb Squad Racing. And Jasper at car 93 takes the lead as they head down the back stretch. Benson is second, Holtkamp third, followed by Craig and Oliver. Speeder's up there. He's come to join me. As Jasper heads into turn number one as your race leader, Benson and Holtkamp. Can you get that photograph?
I sure am. And that number 23 is in a hot pursuit. So fast it has to carry a door handle, smoking all the way. And there's a battle for fourth place.
That's Speedo, his racing broadcast debut. He
right behind the tower. Going to sign some autographs. Got glasses for you. Yes, we're taking the lead down the back stretch with Benson. Oh, and the Craig loops to the car 20 and falls all the way from third to the number five position.
Need to finish at the top four to get your point average is Cleo Jasper.
And Jasper smoking in 93. Mike Benson hanging on to the number two spot. On the old Dutch Coca-Cola scoreboard, four laps down, only two laps remaining.
And Linda's unchallenged in number three.
Down the backstretch. Benson challenging Jasper for the lead. It's a 54 machine. Brand new with us is Myers Buckley. McDonald at the white flag is out. This time around, two foremen as a display with one. Four.
T-shirts up here in the concession stand for sale, but I'll sign autographs on anything.
Hey, during intermission, you want to see all the kids up here?
You bet I do.
All right, Speedo, the Speedway Clown, as we roll out the fast car qualifier for the bomb squad. Happy birthday wishes going out to Randy Willis. Big 3-9, daughter, the green flag is out. Let's go, bomb squad racing. As they head into turn number one, and down the back stretch, the lead belongs to Rick Parker and car five, Jesse Hawkins and Gary Klaster. Second and third track points leader, Spanky Weems is charging hard and fourth. This is a fast car qualifier for the bomb squad. Qualify for the inversion. It's Parker, Hawkins, Foster, and Spanky. Hewing now is in the number five spot. The on driver out. Here comes David Reed, Larry Floyd, and David Rich. The 98 of James Lee rounds out the field with Parker. Down the back stretch. Now he'll start Coca-Cola scoreboard. Two laps down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Foster now being challenged by Hawkins for the number two spot. As they head down the front straightaway, halfway through the fast car qualifier, it's Parker, Jesse Hawkins, and Gary Glasser. Spanky will be the fourth driver to qualify with his point average. David Rich will start shotgun. He won the main event last week. We'll have more now this time around in the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Rick Parker in the number five. Hawkins, Glasser, and Spanky, David Rich trying to pick up some ground. Leads the field down the back stretch. From high above the spurt, Steve Foreman has a white flag ready to fly for Rick Parker in car five. He's got one, four laps to go. And Rick Parker picked up the race victory this evening. The fast car qualifier, only half a lap left. Foster and Hawkins side by side in a battle for second. But it's Rick Parker in car five headed down the front straightaway. The checkered flag will fly for Rick Parker. Foster second, Hawkins third, Spanky Weems comes home fourth.
Well, super soft division. Jim Case will lead him out in car 91. Loving it, Mike Daddy is 16. Row number two will be Roger Gillum in 37 and Tim Stark in 52. Ron Myers in number 11 and Scott Carood in car 28. Loving it, Brian Brown in car number two. And the heat race winner earlier, Chris Nichols in car number 10. Jim McCowan in car number 12. And loving it, rookie chauffeur Mike Hall in car number four. Back in the next row is your point leader from Rolla, Troy Constable in 97. And second in the point standing, Tom Klaus in 42. Third in the point standing, just Robbie Johnson back with us in that double donut machine. Now White Horse in 14. As they look at the field, Steve Jahl comes out in car number 81, Rick Montgomery in 47. Darryl Butcher in 33. And starting dead last tonight, he was the winner here last Saturday night. From House Green, Missouri, we call him the English gentleman, Steve Edgecombe in 65. As our chief steward, Breeze Hanley, will be pulling that Leclerc Auto Sales pace car back to the infield area. The lights go off around the high banks of the I-44 Speedway. 20 times around for our super stock feature. Remember, Constable and Klaus, only 4 points separate them. Robbie Johnson, after missing last week, falls down to the number three spot. So rookie driver Jim Pace will be setting the pace in car number 91 with Lebanon's Mike Daddy to his outside in number 16. Watch Gilliman start, and the boys they call the Lebanon Gang. Fire Brown and Nichols along with Hall. Here they come. Pace is in a fast pace, and we're back to race in action. Oh, and quickly, Ron Byers looping around on that frustration car number 11, and that's going to bring out the yellow flag. And Ron Myers, Ronnie, was involved in a spin last night at the Friday Night Action Track. How he was not hit by a couple of cars as he did that 360 right across the start finish line is beyond me. This will mean an original restart side by side and nose tail. And you can tell by that little incident, these drivers are geared up and ready for their main event. Ronnie, a couple of cars you're going to want to keep your eye on this evening, and one in particular after a week off after being completely shattered at Speedway USA is Robbie Johnson, double donut modified, as he starts near the rear of the field, but he is vying for track championships both at Bolivar and at Lebanon, but he will be starting near the rear of the field at about row six or so, right beside Tom Klaus, so an awful lot of traffic for him to try and go through. Ronnie, after the racing competition wraps up this evening, we'll invite the fans to head down to the pit area. You know what? Red place would be able to be easier to line them up this way. Speedo's still kind of judges booth, inundated with all kinds of fans who are looking for autographs. Speedo is still back there, and he'll stick around for a while to sign some autographs. But the pit gates will be open after the racing competition wraps up this evening. We'll invite you to head down there, visit with your favorite drivers, talk racing, you get race drivers talking. Boy, he goes on for a long time as well. By the way, race fans, got a brand new program for you to listen to on the radio. Starting 1 week from today, 10 o'clock Saturday morning on AM 560 KWTO, we're going to be talking racing with all kinds of drivers between Speedway USA and the I-44 Speedway. Rapid Roy Jensen and Spud Dickinson will be our first two guests at next Saturday morning. 10 o'clock at AM 560 KWCO. As we'll crisscross the field, and he put the yellow light back on. Looks like Ron Myers is headed near the rear of the field. Steve Edgecombe on a House Green, the English gentleman, won the main event last week, and he is starting shotgun this evening. Evidently, the problem with Ron Myers' car number 11, sheet metal is dragging all over the place, Ronnie. So it looks like he may have to head back to the pits. Yeah, and some sheet metal off the front fenders of the crew's going to try and do a quick fix job and hopefully get him back. As the lights will go off, the green flag is in the air. Keith Foreman looks to turn him loose. This time around, and you can see Edgecombe, Ronnie, go from last to first. As Pace will start on the pole. Here we go, Bob. The lights are off. It'll still be Pace and Shad. Pace has got a good jump that time. He'll let the start. Then we see Scott Maroon along with Leather's Brian Brown. As
second in the point standing, Tom Plow, with severe front-end damage as Wayne Lewis heads to the pit area.
Boy, Tom Plow just turned into a sandwich. And he's going to climb out of that machine. And what he's hoping now is that that left front tire is not flat. I think Rod Myers is going to take advantage of this, too. And he's not going back to the pits in that familiar number 11 machine. But boy, I tell you what, Super Stocks are geared up for their feature this evening, and we can't seem to get a lap in. Myers darted out of the pits. What he should have done that time is just to hold up and have started from the rear of the field. But he darted past the track official before they were able to slow him down. You know what? He is in contention for a track championship, and if there's any way at all for him to get back out, it needs only 4 points out of the track point lead at this point. He's on the back stretch being hooked up, and his crew's going to try and do some work in a great big hurry, fans. What do you say? Put your hands together for the chauffeur car 42, Tom Plow. Signed by Michael Waltrip. Pictures of his potential sponsor number 30 machine. We've got either of these two ticket numbers. We've got the pictures, the Dracula clock, and the race again. 66630 and 58322. If you've got out there, though, head up to the tower. And Ronnie, it looks like we've got ourselves a pretty good lineup for the Super Stock A feature. Boy, they're geared up.
Bob, we talked last night at Bolivar with Troy Constable about track position being very important here in the Super Stock division. As our lights will be going off, and a tough break for Nichols on that time. We have no laps down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. We've still got 20 to go. And slowly, last week's feature winner, Steve Edcombe, who was going to start around the 20th spot, has been able to work his way forward just a little bit more and a little bit more. Butcher and Shaw elected to go to the rear. They said, no, we're out here to get a little windshield time. Off to collect a few points, and we'll get a few dollars this season. Here we go. It's going to be Case and Chatty once more. They say the third time's the charm. We're going to find out. The main man, the green juvenile, we're going to go right side. Well, watch Roger Gilliman car to the 37. He's on his charge to the low side. Cockaroo, McCowan, and Mike Paul, three wide by the low side. And here comes your point leader, Constable. As they come off turn four, oh, Garuda, Chatty. Chatty gets it sideways as him and Mike Paul get together. Paul dives to the infield. Garuda also. As the yellow flag comes out once again. Mike Paul doing that agriculture racing. Down low, car number four. And Ronnie, the good news is you call that Constable. Troy Constable, the track points leader, darts to the pitch in car 97. And Richard Putty will take care of the debris high in turn four. The only good news, Ronnie, about these incidents, with the exception of Tom Klaus who's down the backstretch a little while ago, is the fact that there doesn't seem to be an awful lot of damage to these machines. We have seen some great driving by the professionals this evening out of the track, somehow able to avoid the contact. Means we have lost very few cars. Already had three major spins during the first lap of the Super Stock A feature, but we have seen some great driving this evening as somehow contact has been avoided with the exception of Tom Plow. And here he comes out of the pit area, track points leader Troy Constable, who will now head to the rear of the field. Well, that's right, Bob. 1 and 2 in the point standing, taking advantage of these restarts. Klaus, as you see, the car almost looks like a modified. As Case and Gillen now are up on that front row, Brian Brown along with McCowan. The third row has Robbie Johnson and Montgomery. The fourth row is Ed Coleman, Lewis, Myers, and Stark in row 5. As everybody will be bunching up here, getting ready for this restart. Again, Shaw optioning to go to the rear. The lights are off. Here we go. Three strikes normally, you're out. To give them an extra strike here this evening. Case to kill him. Case to set a nice, easy pace. He's got some terrific jumps up on that Super Stock feature. Here they come. I said, those are Coca-Cola scoreboard to see if we get one down. And this performance says, let's go racing.
number two turn.
Tim McCowan, as we said, just one feature win over in his home track at Speedway USA, trying for his second of the season, but his first ever at Lebanon. He's got last week's feature winner, Steve Edsel, through to his bumper in coin of a 65, and watch Wayne Lewis. Lewis knows the fast way around the high banks of the I-44 Speedway, as Edsel now starts to make his move. Coming through Calamity Corner now, Steve Edsel with a hammer down. Gets to the inside, McCowan holds that high line. Meanwhile, Lewis DeCosmo, now watch Edsel. Down off turn number two, McCowan shuts the door on the English gentleman. As they come off for the battle for third and fourth, it's Lewis along with Kate Van Constable. Coming down the front straightaway, we're over halfway home now, and Jim McCowan pulls out to about a three-car length lead. McCowan and Edgecombe. Is Edgecombe trying to cool off his Hoosier tires a little bit? He's starting to make a run on McCowan by the wild side. As Lewis is now third comfortable up to fourth. Down the front as they come one more time. Edgecombe continues to taunt McCowan. He's setting up a path here in the late stages. As these two have now pulled away from Lewis and Constable. But watch Troy Constable now. Constable trying to take over that number three spot. Can he make it back-to-back wins this weekend? Down the front stretch, we're heading for lap number 13. It's McCowan and Edgecombe with about a half a car length separating them. Lewis continues to hold on to third. Edgecombe trying to make the run, but not going to make it right now. Down the back stretch into Calamity Corner. They come upon the last car now of Mike Danny. Roaring down the front stretch, McCowan continues to hold off the English gentleman. McCowan driving the perfect race tonight in car number 12. As Robbie Johnson, Brian Brown now pulls down low. He's out of the action also. Robbie Johnson trying to keep them going a lap down. As we head for lap number 15, it's McCowan and Edgecombe still 1-2. They pull the half a straightaway lead over Lewis and Constable. Case now fifth, Gillum running sixth. Down the back stretch into turn number three, they go one more. McCowan got three car lengths. Edgecombe now gains in the corners, but McCowan has a little more power down the straightaway. Edgecombe now in the short shoot between 1 and 2. Will he make the run by the wild side? As Johnson goes a lap down, 16 down. We're getting ready to head for lap number 17. Edgecombe once again looks to the inside wall and has to get on the binders quickly. Edgecombe low, McCowan high, 17 down, only 3 remain. Down the back stretch they hit. McCowan and Edgecombe continue to go at it. As they come off the number 4 turn, watch Edgecombe down between 1 and 2, and now he's going to try the high side. The white flag will be coming out this time around for Tim McCowan and Steve Edgecombe. As they go bumper to bumper, Edgecombe trying to make the pass in the Calamity Corner. They come off the 4. The white is out. Only 1, 4, 5, 0. Will Edgecombe make it back-to-back 11 of wins, or can McCowan hold on for his first? As they roar down by the wild side, Edgecombe trying to make the pass down low. McCowan pulled away. The English gentleman on the low side of 4. So that's a flag, and it's Tim McCowan. Edgecombe second, Lewis third, Constable fourth, Kate fifth, Gillum running sixth.
In the winner's circle of battle, that was one excited young man. He's going to unstrap all of the safety equipment, take the helmet off, drop the window net. He's going to come out, get that picture taken, get the trophy. The boy just fired up to be in winner's circle right now. Ronnie, here comes Tim McCowan.
Well, this is his second of the year, his first 11, and you're getting to make a habit of this.
Hey, this is fun.
Now it gets fun, doesn't it?
Oh, it's been a long struggle, but it should have been worth it. You know, if it wasn't for all the wonderful races out there to help everyone and all you race fans coming out here to support us and the track, we just really thank you, too.
First of all, Ashton May Steak and Barbecues in Lebanon got a free steak dinner for you. That is good.
I'm a good eater, too.
You're a good eater. First of all, let's talk about that race. Edgecombe was right there with you. Did you look up in the mirror and see him?
I don't believe in mirror driving. Just drive my race.
But you knew he had to be back there.
I knew he was back there.
Let's talk about who you want to thank and who helped you get to the track.
I want to thank Wye for putting this old man starting something at this age, and my boy's my number one fan. there, the Bates boys, all the people in Fairgrove, all the racers out there, especially you fans. We appreciate you coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, he'll head down to the text barn. Let's hear it for tonight's Super Stock winner from Buffalo, car number 12, Tim McCallan.
What a battle, Ronnie, at the front of the field. You can't forget the picture and the kiss there.
By Roy Robertson, car 90. Fairgrove, Terry Taylor, the great star, Jay Patton.
That's him there in the black shirt.
Already owning one feature win this year out of the racing community in Camden, in car 21, Brian Marler. In car 22, on run runs lately for John Ford. The feature
I'm playing the movie and it's leaving you my key.
Three, car 10, Lee McGill. From Iowa. Down the front straightaway for lap one.
the Gateway Connection. Machine normally driven by Lauren Tate over the rear of the field. Well, fans, what do you think? Can Terry Taylor hang on and get the feature win this evening? Is this the night for Brian Marler to get number two? How about Rammy Johnson? Can this be his first win? How about David Bates, the track points leader? Taylor heading into Calamity Corner. Keith Warner looks on the field. Let's go, racing! Down the front straightaway, all four. Car, freight train, riding for the lead. Bates will win that 91 machine. Must maintain his position. Taylor into Calamity Corner. Warner runs to the inside. Johnson flew down his bumper. Bates waiting for the stage.
Is this an emotional sport? You were here 2 weeks in a row, and then we haven't seen you for a while.
This is great, isn't it? Been in a little bit of problems the last couple of weeks, and the car's been fast. It's real discouraging, loading it on the trailer early. Will you stick with it? We got it.
All right. First of all, Dave Anderson and Ashley Mays, have you tried the others yet?
I haven't yet.
You're gonna save them up for the family.
I'm gonna go over there. Yeah, I got that whole crew over there.
You said they took something away from you. What did the crew take away from the car?
They took my power steering away. They said it cost too much horsepower.
So you're telling me you drove that whole race without the power steering pump?
Yeah.
That's tiresome.
Oh, it is. I'm glad we didn't have an extended feature tonight. I would have been tired.
Would have really been tired. Real quick, Brian, before you head to the tech barn and get that picture, let's talk about those sponsors and the people over there in the pits that help you.
Very, very important. Besides the guys that are here at the track with me every weekend, these sponsors that ride on this car make this all possible. If it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be out here. And I've got to thank my most important sponsor of all. That's my wife sitting right up there. She owns the car.
She owns the car. She kind of cuts on the budget just a little bit. You got any other sponsors you want to talk about real quick?
We've got Northtown Collision Center. It's been a real big help to us. Samco Transmission, Marty's Repair, they've been with us for several years, and glad to have them.
Ladies and gentlemen, he'll be starting dead last next Saturday night. Let's hear from down in Tampa to the 21 machine of Brian Moeller.
Ronnie, I made this statement about a month ago when Brian Moeller was in the winner's circle for the very first time. Tell me, am I right?
I'm between the late model stop, the Paul Lawrence, and the gentle giant J.C. Newell, but speaking up is the Reverend Jack Daniel and Bill Gilliman. Here's tonight's starting grid for our late model stock A feature. Mike Aiken in the 41 calls Chris Perry in 41. Row 2 will find Jim Gilbert from out of St. Clair in number 6 and Buffalo, Missouri, Champaign. The third row has Steelville, Missouri, Bill Gillum. To his outside, Ronnie Robertson, 57. Row 4, second in the point setting. You know him as the gentle giant. J.C. Newell in car number 84. And former Ozark Coca-Cola late model sportsman, overall champion, Tony Jackson, 11 and 56. The next row is your point leader, Paul Lawrence, in 92. To his outside from Branson, Missouri, Randy Besser in 24. The next row will have Dave Anderson from Lebanon in car number 4. And Ben Newell from Kenton in 83. Then we will find the number 65 car of Tony Jackson. Scotty Atkinson in 22. Mark Chance will start dead last tonight, as he was the winner here last Saturday night at the I-44 Speedway. And the man we call the ground strong, Jim Garrison, will be starting dead last as that Leckley Auto Sales pace car, state by used car, 29 years in the Leckley County area, will pull right out here.
The racing reverend Jack Daniel is now behind the wheel of Jim Garrison's car, 74.
Track points, very invaluable. Thank you very much on that, Mom. I didn't pick that up on the radio. Settle down.
possibly will this performance be shut the lights off? JC and Carl with the feature win, as has Ben Newell. Tim Jackson has won a couple of features this year, and Marchand got his first feature win of the season last Saturday night in the number 54 car. The lights now go off on the high banks of the I-34 Speedway, and here comes the Reverend trying to gather some very valuable track points. It'll be rookie driver Mike Aiken out of Springfield of Delta Page. Chris Curry on his outside. Here they come, and the green is out. Now we're going to go inside. Oh, watch out. Everybody's trying to go three wide into the corners. And Brandy Fisher, the wild ride on the wild side. Boy, Ronnie, that was a wild ride. We started about a half lap earlier when Sam Payne made contact with one of the cars. You saw a lot of sheet metal. He ripped away from that 49 machine. He was able to do a great job of controlling it. Then Randy Fisher in 24 looped and headed off of turn two. Almost flipped and smacked the wall that time. But a great job by both drivers to somehow maintaining a little semblance of control. Grand American Late Models are in the staging area. They will hit the track next in a 40-lap main event. Then the last chance race for the Bomb Squad. And following that, Ronnie, we're talking about the Bomb Squad A feature. Top four out of the last chance race have an option to immediately move into the main event for the Bomb Squad. And following our late model feature fans, we will have the 50-50 raffle drawing. The winner this evening walks home. One winner. It's better than lottery with $186.50. $186.50 to the 50-50 raffle winner. Want to thank all kinds of fine folks for coming aboard and helping to make the Winston Racing Late Model stock car. Head into the racing action this evening. Carl Lawrence of Lebanon has only a 14-point advantage over Camdenson J.C. Newell, who has a great starting position this evening. The racing reference Jack Daniel is in the number three spot. Larry Roberts and Bill Gillum round out the top five. It looks like Fester's going to take that 24 machine back to the pit area as the caution light will come back on, and Ronnie, the field's going to start to move. LaVoy would have been half a lap down, and now the racing reverend is tacked right onto the end of the rear of the field for a big break for Jack Daniel. As Jim Gilbert makes his way back onto the track in car number 6, he's looking for his first win in the Ozarks. Oh, that's right, Bob. Jim, this is the car that Kim Keith used to own. It was a top-notch play model stock car, still is. And Jim just listed a few of the bugs out. He is a vast improving driver each and every week, but he will have to start out of the rear. He had a right rear tire that was smoking. Evidently, some sheet metal got cut into it. And Sam Payne, if you didn't notice, a lot of the fiberglass body on that 49 car out of Buffalo, shaking real loose, could have caused a hazard as they crossed them from middle ways. Let's see if we'll be set to go here. Yeah, Mr. Foreman still has the yellow lights out. Now they go off. And you can see Ben Newell, the rear quarter panel, on the driver's side, back in that Devco transition number of 83 car, back on the inside of Tim Jackson there. It looks like he might be rubbing, but it's evidently not. Aiken just sets the pace one more time. Here they come. He's whooped them over, and the green flag is out. We're back to race action. And Chris Perry takes the early command. This is the car that Darrell Williams drove to a couple of feature wins here at Lebanon last year. And he's taking a low roll. And Aiken and Roberts get together hard. There goes Ben Newell. Tony Jackson and Dave Anderson do a great job to avoid all that. So you got Aiken, Newell, and Roberts of the Super Shock A feature as FanDuel takes it on the high side. 83 heads to the pit. Ronnie, this is reminiscent of the start of the Super Shock A feature. Larry Roberts also takes off to the pit in car 57. When the Super Shock feature started, we had to go four times before we finally got our underway. You look at Dave Anderson. Ashley Mays and Anderson, one-stop sponsor, Chevrolet Lumen. A lot of front-end sheet metal damage to that number four machine. The team car to Mark Kansas, car 54. And now you wonder, he was unable to answer the bell the last time we tried to start the feature. How about Sam Payne in the pit? If he heads out before restart, he will not be down the lap. And headed out of the pit area is Ben Dole in that 83 machine, and he will report to the rear of the field. But how about Sam Payne out of Buffalo? He's had some strong runs, including a heat race win earlier this evening. He appeared to have a lot of sheet metal damage, but was there any motor trouble to that number 49 machine? Or will he be able to come back out and rejoin the field for an original side-by-side and nose-to-tail restart? Larry Roberts makes it back out in car 57. Particular incident, it was the exit to Calamity Corner and the entrance to turn four, which started the whole melee. Next Friday night at Bolivar, the late model stock, the car just came the track now, will be on hand. Extra laps for extra cash. Will also be giveaway night for Speedway USA. McLean Auto Sales Night. Next week, here at the high banks of the I-44 Speedway. Boy, and that question still remains. Will Sam Payne be able to make it out? Because he is in the heat of the points battle for the late model stock cars headed into the racing action this evening. This again, a side-by-side and nose-to-tail restart with the Grand American late models in the staging area, getting ready for their 40-lap main event this evening. Want to welcome aboard as Mike Aiken comes to Friday Night Action Tracker here at the I-44 Speedway as the field will start to deploy and original restart formation. Getting ready this evening for their 25-lap main event. 40 times around to the late model next.
stretch, Ronnie. It looked like both Sam Payne and Jack Daniel and Jim Garrett's car 74 were slowing. And Daniel takes that machine back to the pit. And you look at the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard with seven. Hotley contested, actually six. Hotley contested laps down, which means 19 remain as we're going 25 this evening for the late model stock. It's been a little bit of a drought for him in the 17 machine. Bill Gillum out of Steelville, two-time I-44 track champion, has the lead with Jackson now put right on his bumper. And Levinas Carl Lauren for the number three position with the gentle giant, J.C. Newell fourth, and Scott Atkinson from Phillipsburg and the Buick Regal in the number five position. And the track point standings heading into the racing action this evening have Lawrence with only a 4-point lead over J.C. Newell. And right now, both drivers are being shown in the top four. And a 14-point advantage for Lawrence over J.C. Newell with Jack Daniel, Larry Roberts, and Bill Gillum, the top five. Oh, Richard Putty's going to have to dodge a little bit. Fresh off his charter flight from New Hampshire. He'll catch that right after the race. Head back there for the cup event tomorrow. Laying down some of the quick fry. And Ronnie, that is a tough, tough break for Jack Daniel.
Yeah, it is, Bob. But he did pick up a few points. And the defending late model stock champion over Speedway USF Oliver will be working hard to get that Lumina prepared for next Friday night's action, because he is not only the defending champion, but he was the winner a week or two ago in Speedway USA. So he'll be starting dead last. So the racing driver from Cowboys Field is trying to make a charge in the point standing.
You talk about tight points battles, and you talk, Ronnie, about a driver who wants to get back to winner's circle as bad as any of them. He is leading the field. It's been somewhat of a dry spell for Bill Gillum, but he knows how to win races.
Well, that's right. When the track was what we call step banking, or it was on the hyzer, Bill was very dominant in this class. When the track got redesigned, the competition got very tough, and the rules changed just a little bit. As you see, we've got six laps down that Coca-Cola scoreboard. They run him through that quick dry down off the turn number two, just a little bit in. He's going to tell him to pick up that pace, so we can kind of blow some quick dry off of there.
Got a good run going tonight, and you talk about a dry spell. Levinas Carl Lawrence has not been used to not being in a victory lane, and it's been almost a month from a driver from Lebanon. Back there in fourth, you see his nemesis in the point standings, the gentle giant J.C. Newell in that Oldsmobile, and Scotty Atkinson is starting to make a few waves. They've got the bugs worked out of that number 22 motor, and young Scotty is just about set to make his start the last half of the season as the lights now go off around the high banks of the I-44 Speedway. Gillum looks in his rearview mirror and he sees that Chevrolet Lumina of Tony Jackson in the NASA auto parts machine. Lawrence flew to his bumper. Atkinson has been utilizing that hydrant. Here they come. And Gillum going through the gears and the green is out. We're back to race on action. Lawrence now tucked his Lumina underneath Jackson's car, trying to make the pass for the number two place. Scotty Atkinson trying to find the fast way around the Dell Giant. Phillip takes that 17 machine on the high side and back to the pit area. There's an awful lot of luck involved in the racing game, and right now, really for the last couple of years, he has had a streak of bad luck, and it looks for a moment like it might end this evening. But Bill Giller, from leader to the pit area, in the space of just about four laps or so, Mike Aiken pulled that 0-1 car down low on the track, and he'll head to the rear of the field. But right now, Jackson leads away in a tight battle with Levin's car, Lauren, to the 92 Chevrolet Lumina, and Camden's J.C. Newell sitting in the number three position. And another driver, not all that long ago running, dating back just a couple of years ago, remember this winning streak. Scott Atkinson at Speedway USA won three consecutive features. He's looking to break into the winner's column, and the guy from Sport Speedway Nation heads to the pit. As the lights now go off, will we possibly get a star? Jackson's going to get what they call that running star. Here they come, and the green goes down. Rebecca, race in action. Jackson with a tremendous throw, that here comes Lawrence once again. Through Calamity Corner now. Jackson goes to the higher.
talk about what? It's a beautiful evening. Drivers are working very hard. Fans with his first in many years. As we call him, TJ, Tony Jackson, climbs out of the car. You look tired.
Rough race, Rob.
Rough race. Looks like you guys had a great race out there.
Well, yeah. Good race. Carl raced me real clean. You got to give him hats off to Carl.
First of all, Dave Anderson, as you know him, acclimated and let him take dinner for you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. What got you back onto the circuit real quick? You've been out for about 3 or 4 years.
Love the race.
Love the race. Let's talk about who helped you get to the track this year.
I didn't mention Glenn Fong last time, and Steve Johnson has done a lot of work on the car. Not much money-wise, but they've done a lot of work.
A lot of work that adds up. You ready for Bolivar next Friday night? Ladies and gentlemen, he'll head down to the check area in the NASA Auto Parts number 56. Roman out from Lebanon, Tony Jackson.
Randy West, please come to the tower, please. Randy West, please come to the tower. And Ronnie, you know what? Not only in a tight points battle,
I have the caution light come back out.
driver Mike Montag from Lemon and Car 73 getting together. Just a couple of changes need to be made in the field, and we should be in pretty good shape and getting ready for a restart. Before with the position. With the position, though, of Montag's car, Montag's going to head back onto the track. It's going to be difficult to latch on to Montag. Look at the front of the pack and running. Steve Holt had a strong run going last time, but eventually Larry Phillips and Bud Jenkins has moved up to the number 8 spot. Young Joe Walsh, you can bet that the Mid Missouri 8 will be going right behind Larry as they try to get their way through this traffic. And Bob, he comes roaring through the pack, so we still got a long way to go.
Here we go, flying.
Thunderbird.
Doug Klein, as we said, when he was about 16 or 17 years old, used to run against Dick Griffel, Bob Taylor, Tommy Mayer, Tom Rasher, and everybody on the ASA circuit. He set out several years. He's been back with us in the last couple of years. And that Pontiac, sponsored by the Clean Machine Car Wash, is looking for that third feature win in a long time. At the level of the very short run, his member. Now look at Steve Simmons. He's got a great round going tonight. Here they come. That's a green drop for Rasher. And Klein and the Pontiac continue to set the pace. They get the time.
for this weekend, but he's had some good showing. What do you say you put your hands together for the 18-year-old charger out of Joplin, car 30, Jamie McMurray? Looks like, after a lot of work, they may need both records to latch
definitely cools the tires down for the drivers. A lot of times that is definitely going to hurt them, or it will help a driver. And sometimes the tire sagging will go away. Either they depend on a long run or a two or three little short runs. We did go for a long green spell, had another one, but now this has kind of thrown things all kind of through the hat.
Down the back stretch slowly as everybody's trying to accelerate. What kind of pace will he set? As they start to get a running start off of three and four, and the green comes out with a rush.
pit area, and it's going to take a while to sort this out. But Larry Phillips, the three-time national champion, still leads the field with 39 down on the Ozark Trophy Solo scoreboard. Man, she comes a long, long way to run with part of my Gateway Connection out of the state of Illinois. What do you say for the driver's car and the clean machine, Doug Klein? Following the late model main event, we will have the drawing for the 50-50 raffle, and someone walks home with $186.50. Back-to-back wins and back-to-back nights for the Sportsman Pickup Cover Sponsor 75 of Larry Phillips.
Well, he's going to sit here and cool down. Larry, got another set gainer from you from Ashley Mays.
Nice. I appreciate these steak dinners. An old guy like me likes to eat.
Like the wild finish there is you and a couple of the other cars did come across and take that checkered flag and staying out there for sure. But starting shotgun in that 20-car field, that was a lot of traffic, a lot of good cars you had to pass.
I believe that's the most fun I've had in a while here. This Kenny Dickinson and the 10 car up there, it's good racing there. I mean, lap after lap. Finally, I just backed up, thought maybe let somebody else do something there. But they... It's good that you can race like that together and not run over each other. Of course, I'm out of touch, Kenny, just a little when I went back.
Just a little bit. You think good close race. Everybody really had their cars hooked up good. And we talked last night, these track motors have really saved late model racing here.
They sure have. This one here probably needs a little freshening up, but we're just going to keep her running there.
We'll let you head down to the check area, pull across the scale, stand. Tonight's late model feature winner in the Sportsman Pickup Coverage number 75.
Larry Pruitt in car 02, George Hewitt Jr. in 41, Terry Holtkamp in car 2, Roy Henson in 24, the 94 of John Colton, Randall Weddle in 32, the 98 of James Reed, the 54 of Richard Fire. In car 90 is Bobby Hammond the 2nd, and out of Canary, Jason Woods in car 92. Top four can once again qualify for the main event, which will be a 15-lap shootout. Well, want to congratulate tonight's 50-50 raffle winner out of St. James. Congratulations. Oh, she should be up here celebrating for watching. Congratulations going out to Donna Bundy, walking home with $186.50 this evening. Side by side and nose to tail is the way they are scheduled to start. And after the main event, which comes up next, we'll open up the pit fans invited to head down there and visit with their favorite driver. And James Reed in car 98 takes her on the high side. He's headed back to the pit area. See if we'll get a start this time around as Steve Foreman has that green flag in his hand. A 10-lap shootout with the top four moving forward into the A feature. And the lights will go off, and it's Pruitt and Huey, Hanson and Holtkamp, Carlton and Weddle, the 54 of Fire, and the 90 machine of Hammond. And Jason Woods, Keith Foreman will say this time, let's go racing! A 10-lap shootout with the top four going forward, Holtkamp with the 0-2 machine. And Pruitt takes her down the backstretch, and Holtkamp still with problems running down low. Across the start finish line, they will come the first time. Larry Pruitt in the 0-2 machine with one down. Remaining on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. Huey running second, Hanson and Woods third and fourth. The odd man out now is John Carlton. Woods looks to be inside of Hanson in the battle for third. Pruitt in the 0-2 machine, down the front stretch. He'll have two laps down, eight laps remaining. With the Pearson A feature in the staging area, Pruitt takes it down. Second as they go on a calamity corner. Woods and Hanson and Colton. Weddle riding in the number 6 position. But it's Larry Pruitt with 3 laps down. 7 laps remaining in the last 10th race. On the high side, Richard Byers takes 54 to the pit. It's Larry Pruitt and George Huey Jr. A little more than half the straightaway ahead of Jason Woods and Roy Hanson. And now down in the low side, Bobby Hammond down the backstretch. Let it throw it to race later going into Calamity Corner. This will be the midway point of the last chance race for the bounce squad. 5 laps down on the Ozark Coca-Cola scoreboard. 5 laps remaining. Top four head back to the field. leading them out of the pit area. Darren Weaver in car 7. Mike McMullen in 28. That's Al Yarborough in car 1. Cleo Jasper 93. Mike Benson in 23. Linda Craig in car 20. Rick Barker in 5. Rick Oliver in 12. Jesse Hawkins in 06. Gary Foster in car 15. Robert Reeves in car 6. There is your track points leader. Spanky Weeds in car 11. Chris Schumacher in 11. The 66, driven by Daniel Gray. On hand with us in car 26 is Mark Wood, Brita Holliday, and 88. There are your final four qualifiers. George Huey Jr. in 41. Larry Pruitt in 02. Randall Weddle in 32. And the 92 of Jason Wood. And starting shotgun. Last weekend, feature winner at the I-44 Speedway in the 00 machine, David Rich. Keith Foreman has the lights off. The Ford Mustang will pull off the track this time around. Weaver and McMullen lead them down. Yarborough and Jasper and Rosen, Craig and Benson. They go out of Calamity Corner. Let's go racing! 15 times around, and McMullen to the lead, 28. Take your lead, heading in and out of turn one. Jasper looking for his first win of the season to the low side as they go 3 deep near the rear of the field. And 3 and 41 into Calamity Corner. Take your pick, but Gary Kloster at 15, the odd man out. Vaulting forward at the track point standings, and now it looks like his night is through. Cleo Jasper, the race leader, with a lap down on the Ozark Coca-Cola 4-4. Linda Craig is going to head to the pitch at car 20. Car accident with only one lap down, 14 laps remaining. This will be a nose to tail restart as Darren Weaver heads to the pitch in car 7. Bring the field to a stop, it'll be easier to line him up this way. AM 560 KWCO, Countryside Mall, Park, and of course Ashley Mays, Bacon, Barbecue, and Mother's. Thank them for being along. KCLQ 107.9, Bailey TV Radio Jack, the Boatman Bank of Pulaski County, First Ozark Coca-Cola, Dr. Pepper Bottling Company, LaFleet Auto Sales, Central Bank, Big Daddy's Family Restaurant, American Auto Supply, Jones Tire, Filler, Lindsay Chevrolet, and Country Kitchen for all being on hand. Jasper, the race leader, with a lap down and 14 remaining. McMullen on his bumper. Keith Foreman has a green flag in his hand. The safety equipment back to the infield. 14 laps remaining as the lights go off. Jasper, McMullen, Yarborough, Benson, Reed, Spanky, Shoemaker, Rich, along with Jasper into Calamity Corner. Keith Foreman says, let's go racing! Down the front straightaway they come. Jasper, McMullen, Yarborough now challenging for the number 2 spot. Robert Reed looking to lift off 40 points and he's up to the number 4 spot. Track points later, Spanky Weeds heads up to 5th, bustling by Mike Benson. We'll have 2 laps down this time around. Daniel Graves in car 66 got it high, lost the tire, which is still rolling loose on the back stretch. He's going to need a tow back to the pit. Looks like we've got ourselves a good lineup and keep forming. We'll turn the lights off. The green flag in his hand, getting ready for a six-lap bomb squad shootout. Trying to hold off the charges of Spanky Weeks and Robert Reed. In the calamity corner, there will go. Foreman will look over the field, and he will say this time around. Evidently, there may be a little bit of debris on the track right now. That's why Holliday pulled low in that 18 machine. So still 6 laps remaining on the old.
Ozark Pro Control scoreboard.
Richard Putty will go ahead and take care of that debris. Boy, he's going to have a late charter flight to New Hampshire tonight. Buy your own plane, I guess you can afford that.
Let's see if the light, well, Holiday gets her spot back because she came down to talk to the official for safety purposes. So Holiday will head back to her original spot in the lineup as the field will take one more tour around the I-44 Speedway. Now Holiday heads to the pits of car 18. So the lights go off. Six laps remaining in the Bob Squad A. Rick, Banky, Reed, Yarbrough, and Jasper. Keith Foreman's going to look over the field. This time around, and Hawkins goes to the pit 0-6. Keith Foreman will say, let's go racing.
Good run.
Thank you.
A little bit tiresome there, wasn't it?
A little bit. Pushing a little bit. Got to work with it. It's kind of hard.
Not that bad. Got a steak dinner for you from Ashley Mays here in Lebanon. You use that other one yet?
No, but now I can take my wife.
You take your wife. The place to go before the races. You'll be able to get down here early enough for next Saturday night. Let's talk about what David Rich has got goals for the future. You want to move up a class, or what are you wanting to do?
Yeah, I've got a sponsor here tonight that's helped me out. He's out. Counting every day looking for something new. He's going to look at a Allen's Modified tomorrow. And if that don't work out, he's got a sportsman he's looking at. So that will happen here soon, I hope.
Good deal for you. Well, we're going to let you get down to the tech barn, David. But before we do, you can talk about those sponsors that helped you get here.
I want to thank Gary with Apple Mobile Home Moving, Bill's Muffler, Mike Rays. He changes all my tires for free. And myself, Portable Fencing.
That's about it. Need tires with these bombers, don't you?
Need a lot of them.
Need a lot of them. Let's hear it. For tonight's Bomb Squad feature winner, that's two in a row out of Springfield, David Rich. Ronnie, next week, if all